One of the most controversial and polarizing topics in the nation, and that would be the gun debate. With us now from New York is Jeff Nugent, an NRA member and older brother of another Nugent, gun rights activist Ted Nugent. And thought we had a picture of him. There he is. He's proudly showing off a pair of semi-automatic rifles. Of course, there's one big difference between the two brothers. Jeff, you say you support some gun control, like background checks, and you're not in any fight with your brother. You're actually able to sit down and have a civil conversation?
We have civil conversations regularly. I posted a Washington Post op-ed piece 2 weeks ago, which we had a tremendous response from. And of course, they highlighted it by Jeffrey Nugent being in strong disagreement with his brother Ted, which I am on the subject of background checks. That, frankly, I don't do well in a politically correct environment. So, to be very direct, I'm furious. I'm furious that we have these 10,000 pound elephants in every living room in the country, and that there's a lot of talk about gun control and about reducing the levels of violence, but it's all talk. I think that my focus right now is to try to make something happen and to stop the mindless debate.
Make it clear for us, Jeff. What do you want to see happen?
What I'd like to see happen is really two things. That I have joined an organization by the name of Evolve. And what we're all about is to represent the majority of Americans. And it's just come out again in a poll this morning that in excess of 80% of Americans are in strong support of enhanced background checks. Now, it boggles my mind how our elected officials and the NRA are not paying attention to the majority of the people that they represent. I don't get it. I had a great conversation with Senator Manchin from West Virginia yesterday, and I have studied his bill that he partnered with Senator Toomey. I've compared that with the Grassley-Cruz Amendment, and there are differences between the two, some minor, some more than minor. Mm-hmm. But the point is, they both were DOA when they made it to the floor of the Senate. That's unconscionable. So right now, a lot of people talking, a lot of organizations are developing to try to get something done.
Well, I know that one of the things Mayor Bloomberg is doing through his gun control group is he's targeting Democrats who voted against background checks in ads online and on television. Do you think that sort of thing is effective?
Well, I do, but it's not limited to Democrats. I think there's a core group of rational, balanced Republicans as well as Democrats who understand that there is a common ground. And frankly, back to this 10,000 pound elephant, I've always believed that you eat an elephant a bite at a time. And enhancing these background checks are one of the best ways to make a short-term improvement by filling in the holes that exist in the current background check process. And that, for whatever reason, nobody wants to make a change. And I just don't get it. So we're pulling together an expanded group of people. And I know that change can be made. I was in the early days of the Partnership for Drug-Free America, and they changed a culture about drug abuse in this country that no longer made drug use as cool as it was. It wasn't 100% effective. And no one is going to be 100% effective.
And I have to ask you this because I can hear some in our audience who are in favor of more gun control. And, you know, we're split as a nation over this issue, right? We're still split, saying that your brother has a big part in nothing getting done in Washington because he belongs to the NRA. He's on its board.
Well, he is, and he's a very articulate spokesman for the rights that are guaranteed by the Second Amendment. And they have developed, Ted in particular, has developed a black and white definition of what that means. Now, I don't want to get into a direct comparison of me and my brother. He's my closest friend. And, you know, we've had recent talks that tell me that we're closer in our opinions and recommended actions than we are further apart. One of the big differences, frankly, Carol, is the priorities. There are significant issues with the judicial system, that there are felons. In fact, there was a recent one in California, I understand, in the last couple of days. He was let out of prison within 12 hours. He broke into a home, killed the mother and father, I believe killed the grandparents as well, sexually assaulted a three-year-old daughter in front of the other children in the house at the time. That was within 12 hours of being let out of prison. And he had a previous conviction of violence using a gun. Now, I think that the people who let him out, including Governor Jerry Brown, should go to prison in light of what they let this individual do.
Well, I wish I knew more about the case so I could question you, but I don't know about that case, and I'll just be honest with our viewers. I don't know.
Those cases are all over. They happen every day.
I understand. Thank you so much, Jeff Nugent, for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Good. Thank you for having me.